Where's my father?
He's inside with Madame Consuelo.
Maningning. Maningning. You didn't tell me that you were coming to visit. Maningning.
I know about your secret. You can't hide anything from me. Is it true? Father.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Does it have to come from me? Do you want to hear it from me? That you raped my mother? Do you really want to hear it from me? That you ruined my mother's life? Father, tell me the truth. Is it true? Is it true? I'm here because you raped my mother? Father, I have to know the truth.
That's enough, Maningning. Do you want to know what really happened? Yes. Everything that Rosa told you is true. Your father raped me. He violated me.
Forgive me, Virgie. I regret everything I did.
Animal! You know that
Mother.
All this time, I never have really forgiven you, and I never, ever
Mother,
will.
That's enough.
This is what I have been dreading, that she would get hurt. What will I do now? What will happen to Winning now, you animal? What now? You have already ruined my life. Now you have ruined my Ningnings.
Mother, please. Mother, please, enough. Mother. After what my father has done to you, did you ever hate me and Mayumi?
No. I love you both. At first I did. But then, with the help of Joel, I have finally learned to love you. He was the one who told me that I should love you and your sister, because you two were the best thing that happened in my ugly past.
I've been thinking that maybe the reason why I always had bad luck all my life is because I'm the result of my father's crime.
It's not your fault. You shouldn't even be involved in this. It's mine and your father's fault. I have kept my past a secret. Because I don't want you to get hurt. I just let myself carry all the pain.
I covered up the crime that you committed against Virgie. I did it, even if I knew it was wrong, because you're my son. But now, You are being haunted by your past. And it would be a much bigger heartbreak if Maningning will leave us. And I don't want that to happen. So you better pull yourself together, because I am falling apart.
Mother. Mother, are you all right? Should I take you to the hospital?
No. No. No need. I just don't want to lose Maningning. She is the only blessing that I ever got. I don't want her to get hurt. All our problems in the past, we solve them using our money. But that's not going to work with my grandchild. And she won't come back to us just because of that. I just don't know what to do anymore. What else can I do, Sigmund?
Don't worry, Mother. I will find a way. Ever since I was a young boy until now, you have always bailed me out of trouble. Now it's my turn to fix things.
Sigmund, bring back Maningning to me, please. Please. Please.
Yes, Mother. Come get some rest.
I know it was a mistake to hide it. Because no matter how many times you wanted to know the truth, I still kept it from you. I hope you can forgive me.
That's all in the past now. Maybe it's time for us to start over again.
Thank you, Maningning.
Mother, I've been thinking. Will you ever forgive my father?
It has been 20 years. But up to this time, the pain that your father caused me has not yet healed. I have to deal with this on my own. I hope you understand.
Yes, I understand.
Thank you. But don't worry. I will work it out that someday I will be able to forgive your father and make peace with him. Because I haven't totally turned my back on the possibility of forgiving him.
Shut up!
Do you understand what I'm saying? You have to keep quiet.
You and me, we are one and the same.
What are you talking about? You don't know me.
We will die here alone. Everyone forgets the ones who end up in this institution. Our families and friends, husbands, lovers, everyone. They will never, ever come back for us. You will die here alone.
Why is it that you need to see me?
Come and follow me, Cassandra.
What are we doing here?
Are you double-crossing me?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Rosa has returned. She's going to kill Maningning.
I know nothing of Rosa's plans.
You don't know? Maybe you're just pretending. She hasn't come to you? Or even called you? Well?
I know what you're capable of doing if I lie to you, Harry. I'm telling the truth. If you want, I'll help you find Rosa. I'll call her. I can easily wrap her around my finger.
Go ahead. Call her. Right now.
Later, after we're done with my father. And don't ever order me around again. You still owe me, Harry. I don't care if her life is ruined, or if she goes to jail, or if people cry over her dead body. If you really want to save Maningning from Rosa, let me taste my sweet revenge on my father first. Excuse me.
Maningning.
I've been wondering for so long. I wanted to know more about myself. Now that I know, it hurts. It's a curse, Eric. I will never be happy. Even if we get married. I have no right to feel and experience any kind of love. Because I was born from rape.
Don't be silly. Maningning, I love you. Just the way you are. No matter how you came into this world. What matters is that you're here with me. And don't you ever, ever think that you were unworthy of love. Because I love you. I love you more than what you think you deserve. That's enough. Okay? Stop crying. It's okay.
Nurse? Nurse? Nurse?
Nurse, Mrs. Proterra.
Why are you still up? Do you know it's time for bed?
It's because I need to call my husband.
You can't make any calls at this hour.
But I need to talk to my husband. They haven't visited me in a while. Maybe something bad might have happened to them.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Proterra, but that's really not possible.
Look, I am a patient here, not a prisoner.
Let me go get your medication to help you sleep.
I don't need that. I don't want to sleep. What I want to do is to talk to my husband. Nurse?
You.
Nurse?
Come
please
with me.
Give me that phone call or else
Let's
I will
go.
Sue this hospital. Nurse? Nurse?
Could your grandmother and I speak with you?
Please come in.
Maningning, I know that asking for forgiveness won't make up for what I did to your mother. But if I have to beg for it my whole life, I will do it.
Don't ask for my forgiveness. Ask for mother's.
I also did something wrong to you. We tried to hide the past. Even if I was hounded by my conscience, I just kept my guilt secret. Because I might lose you. And I don't want that to happen.
We have made a lot of mistakes, Maningning. I would do anything to bring back the past. I would change my decisions. If only I knew you were my grandchild. I wish I could have fixed this mess. If only I did not keep Sigmund from your mother.
Maningning, please give me one more chance to fix things.
Did it ever occur to let me know the truth? Or did you plan to hide it from me forever?
Maningning, I always knew that you would find the whole truth one day.
But Rosa beat you to it.
Rosa has no business interfering with our lives.
You're right. Rosa did that to ruin us all.
Damn that Rosa. We cannot allow her wicked plans of ruining our family to succeed.
I know that. I will not let that happen either. I will find Rosa before she can completely ruin us all.
Hey, what brings you here?
Charles, do you have any news on Rosa?
Did the police find out where she is?
No, I'm sorry. Hello? Hello? Hello, who's this?
Do not shout at me, Charles.
Mother?
Good day, Virgie. Someone told me I might find you here. Can I talk to you?
What is it?
We have learned that you were once friends with Mrs. Rosa Pere. Maybe you know of a place back then where she could be hiding now.
I've cut off my friendship with that woman a long time ago. But I do know one person who might be able to tell where that awful woman might be hiding.
Who is it?
It's Cassandra, Maningning's half-sister.
You said you were going to see me, but you didn't show up. What happened?
I changed my mind.
Ask her where she is.
I trusted you again, but you tricked me.
You're the one who wanted to trick me. Yes, you. You would throw me in jail.
How did you know?
I saw you.
And that detective. The bald one.
You mean you were following me? Mother, answer me!
You rest now, Charles. I'm going now. It hurts me to see you with Maningning and your brother, Eric.
You're here.
Mother.
Mother, where are you?
Hmm.
She can see us.
Rosa?
Rosa!
Rosa!
Mother!
Come back here!
Hi.
What is that?
Your dress.
Oh, Armand. I don't know how I can repay you for the things you've done. I don't know where I can start.
I know that this is out of line for me to say this to you, but I really can't deny this feeling that I've been hiding from you. I love you. I love you, Sandy. Thank you. Here, you should try it. Well, am I right? Hey, here you go. I notice you're starting to like these, so I bought you a whole bunch. I'm not rushing things, Sandy. Because I don't want you to think that I want anything in exchange for what I've done. What I want to know is if I have any chance to win your heart.
It's not hard to love somebody like you, Armand.
Then marry me.
Do you take Armand as your husband, to have and to hold, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, till death do you part?
To you. Stop this. You have to be strong, Sandy. Pull yourself together. Sandy, be strong.
Armand is gone, Cheetah. What
Stop
other
it.
Reasons do I have for a living?
Be strong for him. No, Sandy. You have to be strong.
Armand.
So who do you think is the suspect here?
Well, I think here she comes.
Well, we're about to find out. How many times have we been here before? Nothing happens. I'm sure the chief will come up with something right now.
What's this?
Is that her?
Do you think she'll tell us?
I hope so, Virgie.
What are you doing here?
Where is Rosa?
Wait, Virgie.
Tell us. Where? Where is she?
Doctor, how is Eleanor? Why did you call for us?
I'm sorry to say that we haven't seen any improvement with regard to your wife's condition, Mr. Bergera. The reason I called you out here is because she's been calling out your name. Even you, Madam Consuelo, she was calling for you. She's afraid that you might have forgotten her.
Well, that's not true. My son and I were busy with something.
Thank you for being here. It will be a big help to Mrs. Bergera if you visited regularly.
Mm-hmm. Well, I hope you understand, Doctor. We can't deal with everything all at once. We have to fix our problem at home first before we can promise Eleanor that we will visit her more often.
I understand.
Hold it, Mother. I'm obliging myself to visit Eleanor if that's what it takes for her to get better.
Thank you, Mr. Perchera.
Come on, go ahead.
Virgie, that's enough,
please. Come on, fight back. Go ahead. There are cops here. I will send you to jail. That's where you belong. Come on.
You have the guts to threaten me? Keep in mind, Virgie, you are in my own house. I can charge you with trespassing.
So why don't you? Just try it. Let's see who the law is going to side with. You, a crime suspect, or me? You haven't answered my question. Where is your friend? Where is Rosa?
Do you think that after what you did, I will tell you where she is? You know, Virgie, my advice to you and my sister Maningning is to wait. Because I am certain that it is only a matter of time before Rosa will come to you.
How can we get that girl to confess where Rosa is really hiding?
I don't know.
I'll go get Mrs. Bertera.
Okay, Doctor, thank you. Sigmund, I hope you meant what you said to the doctor earlier. You must remember, we have a lot of making up to do with Maningning.
Mother, when I told you that I will fix all the lives that I have ruined, I didn't mean just Maningning and Virgie, but also with Cassandra and Eleanor. Same with mine as well. I'll do whatever it takes to prove myself to them.
If it's for your child, I could still believe you. But to fix the problem between you and your wife? Sigmund, for you and Eleanor to patch up, you need to have at least a little love for each other. Now, can you truly tell me if you still have love for her?
Mother, all I want is for Eleanor to get out of here, for her to recover and get better.
Because you feel sorry, or do you feel guilty? Sigmund, sympathy will not solve the problems between you and your wife.
Sigmund? Mother? Sigmund?
Oh, I'm so happy that you're here. I thought that you've already forgotten about me. Please, please promise me that you will never leave me here.
Just get well. You are still welcome in our home.
We'll find Rosa soon.
She'll track me down, Eric.
What makes you say that?
Because she blames me for what happened to her. Her husband left her. You and Charles became distant. She won't stop until she's destroyed my life as well.
I won't allow that to happen. Even if her blood runs through my veins, my heart belongs to you. Don't worry.
For Pete's sake, I'm getting so restless here. What is Sir Harry doing inside?
Come on. May I remind you? First rule. Don't go inside.
You're afraid of Sir Harry now, Octopus?
What are you talking about? I'm not. We're tight, okay? That's why I'm staying put. Second rule. Don't look inside. I repeat, okay? For your own benefit. Don't go in. Don't even look, okay? Whoever looks inside is a peeping Tom. Got that, boys? Can I borrow that?
Harry.
Hey. I thought you wouldn't show up.
I was being followed by the police. I managed to escape them. What is it that you wanted to tell me?
This won't take long. You're about to grieve your father's death.
What's the plan?
Oh, sir. This meeting is earlier than scheduled.
I'm just confirming if the transaction will push through tomorrow. I hear you've been neglecting your business. That's bad for people like me who trust you. Make sure that the transaction will push through.
I was just busy with something else.
More important than your obligation to me?
The transaction will push through, don't worry.
Don't mix your own problems with business. If not, it will surely get you in jail. I don't want any of us to fail. Because if that happens, I will be dragged down with you.
I won't allow our group to go down because of me. After this transaction, I will turn over our territory at the port to someone else.
Just make sure that the transaction will push through. After that, if you want to get out of this business, you're free to go.
Thank you, sir. Tomorrow night, Sigmund will have a transaction at the port. That's where I'll kill him.
That's very good. I've been waiting a long time to hear you say that.
After I'm done with Sigmund, I'll be back for Rosa. So be ready.
So what did Harry say?
That's it. He's going to kill Sigmund.
Can you just imagine? If Sigmund gets killed, then Meneng Ning will inherit a lot of money.
Is that what matters to Meneng Ning? What's important is to let her know Harry's plan.
Wait, hold it right there. What if we just let both of them go and finish each other off? Don't you get it? So we won't have any problems. You see, we won't have any more bosses telling us what to do all the time, right?
This is for Meneng Ning. I'm not afraid of Harry anymore. Armin paid with his life, so we should be ready too.
I'm with you, okay? I'm ready to do what Armin did, but then I'm just saying let's not get involved because it's a big risk. And if Meneng Ning learns about this, she'll only get worried and feel helpless.
Bukul, this is about her father. What if it was your grandmother? Who could get killed? See?
All right, let's go. Meneng Ning?
Hey, so why the long faces? Is there a problem?
I'm right on target.
It's Harry and Cassandra. They're up to something so bad. They plan to kill your father tomorrow.
Where are you off to again? What? What's the matter with you? Haven't you learned your lesson? Aren't you afraid of Rosa? Aren't you afraid that she'll kill you the same way she killed Armand and your sister?
Mother, this is important.
So where are you going?
To my father.
What?
Harry is planning something against Father.
Meneng Ning, don't get yourself involved in this mess that your father started.
But this is the only way I can think of so you two can patch things up. I won't allow it to end just like this, Mother. I want to give him another chance so you can get rid of all the hurt you're carrying with you.
The hurt that your father caused me will never go away. You're not going. I won't allow it. Even if you get mad at me, even if you curse me, even if I have to tie you up, I won't allow you to leave. Stay here. Go inside. Go upstairs. You're not leaving. Habagat? Meneng Ning? Breakfast is ready. The food might get cold.
Oh, wow! Eggs! Is there ketchup?
Over there. Where's your sister? She's usually awake at around this time. Go call her.
I think she's sleeping.
Meneng Ning! Breakfast is getting cold! Meneng Ning?
Eggs.
Meneng Ning? Meneng Ning, get up. It's time to eat. And don't even think about going out today, okay? I will have someone mind the stall at the port. Whatever happens to Harry and Sigmund, I want to make sure that you're here so I can watch over you. You're not leaving. Meneng Ning? Meneng Ning? Meneng Ning? Meneng Ning?
Habagat!
Mother?
Where's your sister?
She's asleep.
She's not there. Where is she?
I don't know.
How come you don't know? Don't leave the house, okay? If your sister comes back, tell her to wait for me. I'm going to look for her.
All of my men are ready for the transaction tonight. Don't worry. I'm on top of the situation. You can count on me. I'll be there. Thank you. It's Sigmund. Keep a close eye on tonight's transaction.
Myrna?
Hi, Virgie.
Eric.
Yes?
Have you seen Mening Ning?
I haven't seen her. Did she drop by?
Not yet.
That daughter of mine is so stubborn. I specifically told her not to leave the house, not even step outside the house.
Why? What's going on?
It's Harry. He'll kill Sigmund. My daughter will get involved. I just feel that something will happen. Please come with me. We have to find Mening Ning, Eric.
I'll go with her, Mother.
Let's go.
Virgie, I think we need to ask the police to help us first.
All right.
We'll go ahead, Mother.
You both
take
care.
Thank you, Myrna.
Habagat! You know, Habagat, if you're thinking about your problems, come with me. Let's go out, so you can forget about them for a while.
Listen, no matter what we do, I can't help but worry about Mening Ning. From the way Mother's acting, it's as if something bad will happen to her.
So, what do I have to do to make your worries go away? Do you need a hug? Or do you need a kiss?
I need Sandy.
What?
What I mean is, I need to talk to Sandy. Perhaps this has something to do with Mening Ning's fight with her sister. And Sandy might know about it.
Okay, fine. Whatever.
Hey. Don't tell me that you're jealous.
Me? No, no way. Although, I am insulted. I know that until now, you still love Sandy. Especially now that her husband is dead. But, please don't insult me. Don't rub it in. Okay?